so people to refresh. If you would be so kind.
All means I gotta refresh. Damn it.
We are back live, guys. Sorry about the little delay. Waiting for Rambo to say he's ready. Sorry about that. Overlay, in-game overlay should be working now.
In-game overlords?
In-game overlord should be working now. Just gonna bring it up. Looks like, yep. Overlay looks good. Hopefully it's sized properly. We will see when we go in. I guess we're gonna get going. Waiting for Rainbow versus Ostagy. Waiting for Rainbow to say he's ready. Waiting is what we do here. We are very patient casters.
That's what they call it. That's my second.
Yeah, he's the silence. His second Twitter, you can follow him at thepatience@twitter.com.
The patience.
We will wait till the end of the earth for a cat game to cast. Rainbow ready. We got a PBT or ZBT here, guys. StarTale's very own Rainbow versus Gosu's Ostagy. Oh man.
Now we know that Rainbow does not play like any other Terran player.
Not in the slightest.
He goes for...
Wait. Time out. Why are people still playing on Metalopolis? What is going on? Ugh. I am so upset right now. Okay, continue with your Rainbow talk, but I had to point out that this is Metalopolis, and I'm upset.
Well, we'll do some quick introductions here in the north position as the blue Terran player. There you can paint happy clouds, you can paint nice calm rivers, or you can paint rainbow. And his opponent in the south position! The Zerg player playing the purple pieces, he is Ostagy. And that's the way it rolls.
That was the best intro ever.
I was saying, Rainbow plays kind of off kilter and off center usually, so you really don't know what to expect from him. And that's what I feel like. Some players sometimes you can be very someone like Idra. You kind of know what he's going to be doing. He's going to play very very standard. So where Rainbow is just all around the map. He is going for Thor rushes, you know, doing all these weird kind of funky builds. They may not be the best builds in the book, but they certainly will throw your opponent off, and they are effective to some degree.
Yeah, definitely. I love watching Rambo play. Being a Terran player myself, he's just like MVPs. The game genie Terran has just everything, every possibility that can go in his head. He does everything. You never know what to expect from Rambo. And he executes them almost perfectly. I mean, it's not just like, LOL, I'm gonna do this. He just, very creative, very, unpredictable. Very hard opponent to predict. Impossible to predict, some would say. We'll see if Ostagy, though, will be able to predict him. He does open hatch first, pull and gas following. On 16 supply. Very, very standard opener here. We are seeing one gas from Rainbow. Did Ostagy scout that, though? He has not seen his opponent's base, so he does not know about the one gas. More likely, though, it's just going to be Reactor Hellion Expand. No factory just yet. Going down a little bit late here, but it's going to time out nice with the one gas with the reactor. Oh, Command Center. Whoa.
Yeah, this is what we're talking about. See, you cannot predict what he's going to do.
I had to fool myself trying to predict that reactor or that factory going down, but what it's probably going to be is a fast CC with very, very fast tech behind it. But there I go predicting Rainbow again. We'll have to see. You have to utilize that gas somehow. I'm really curious to see how it's going to be. He's already banked up to 200.
Mm-hmm.
This is cool, man. Catching this Overlord, though. Ooh, will he go for the Overlord? Oh, that's a huge loss there for us. He did this early on. He has already supply bought. Shinai's gonna have to build two overlords. Still nothing in production. That SCV on the high ground is so good. It looks like that's definitely... it barely falls. So now only one overlord on the way. That's just gonna put them at 28 supply. That's gonna keep them supply blocked. Still no second overlord queued up. So Ossigy in an awkward spot. And there goes that fast reactor Hellion. Still has a good amount of gas. So we could be seeing a very fast starport go down behind this. The new meta for TVZ right now is this nice little, you get the 1-1-1, of course, after a gas, and you go for Cloak Banshees, and, I mean, people are learning that Zergs have found out how to clean up Hellions pretty easily. And now, the Banshees, they do their harassment, but then they're denying creep spread as well. It's a nice fumble style.
This is a pretty creative build here from Rainbow. I mean, in Reactor Hellion expansion, you typically get your factory up, pardon me, before Command Center, but the way that Rainbow does it is he doesn't quite focus on mineral only. I would have liked to see him maybe not get such a very fast, actually going for a very fast third Command Center. Ooh, okay. I was gonna say maybe not so much get three guys on Command Center all the time, maybe go two early on and then move into three, do maybe a little bit more economy managing, but I'm sure he's timed it out so that where he gets his reactor right away as well. So this is really, really interesting, and actually he's going to transition straight into Makoff's 3 base here. So Rainbow early on at this point is playing extremely, extremely greedy.
Yeah, very, like this is any form of 1-2 base roach timing attack, this just kind of dies. Like, you can't, the fast third CC with fast double factory is going to be producing lots of Hellion. C-Chain is going to be very, very delight, just because he's going to have so much gas on the extra factories that it's going to be rough, but Rollhorn is finishing up. We'll see if he queues up a bunch of roaches. His larva count is pretty low right now. He has two roaches on the way. Melee upgrade on the way as well. So it's probably just going to be building these roaches to hold off any threat of real Hellions. Just kind of, push them back. And then he's going to transition into, a mid-late game style. Which we have yet to see what it could be. Audio still fixed yet.
I really, really want to see like a roach bust here, or like a roach baneling bust, but instead he's gonna elect for that third base. But yeah, how can you make that call right now with the scouting information that Astoji has? He's really only seen Reactor Hellion. He doesn't know that Rainbow's going for Mech right now. He doesn't know that Rainbow has that third base, so he's playing it relatively safe from here. I mean, that third base should be, will definitely be really very, very safe, as long as he doesn't get countered by these Hellions, doesn't get caught with a drone transfer. And, Astoji is on top of this, though. He has his queens already positioned near that third base and anticipating the Hellions. And are they going to move towards that main base? No, they're going to retreat. Very smart moves from Rainbow. He is down 50 supply, but that doesn't matter, though. Supply counts aren't a really big factor at this point right now, because Rainbow's army is going to be trading very, very efficiently if it is in position.
Rainbow, or Astoji, has to be like, freaking out right now. He just scouted his opponent's base, saw that there was still no expansion just yet. I mean, this is just such weird and awkward timings here from Rainbow. He's just carrying that natural filing, has SCVs transferring, he's got the Hellions on the field. Siege check just finishing, putting up the siege tanks. Up to four factories right now. Two of them producing just pure Hellions at the moment. Other two producing the siege tanks, of course. Needs those siege tanks to do any really roach aggression. There are some movement across the map. Four more on the way. Melee attack about to wrap up. Rainbow's in a pretty solid position right now. He is supply blocked pretty hard, though. Four supply depots on the way. That's the problem with building this many command centers early on. You just keep, have so much free supply that you kind of forget your depots. And it tends to happen more often than not, where you get that fast third CC, someone supply blocks themselves.
Especially going mech, too, where mech takes up a lot of supply very, very fast. And the production that Rainbow's outputting right here, four factories, two with tech labs, and two with reactors, he's pumping out, a potential of... I can't even count how many, let's say 14 supply at a time here, just in factory count. So you have to be making supply deals constantly, each and every single time here. And, you will get supply block, but, as long as you stay on top of that, you can be constantly producing absolutely devastating army. Looks like we saw a couple roaches here at the third base. They are going to get cleaned up by Rainbow. And it looks like Astoji is going to be taking that ever so elusive gold base that we see nowadays in the middle of the map.
I don't like Moloblus. No, said this. I don't like this map. Let's move across the map. 17 roaches on the way for Asuji. No third base just yet for Rambo. Weird little siege tank timing here. For the most part, I mean, he doesn't look like he's, like, if any form of fast unit timing was there, Rambo would have kind of just died.
Yeah.
This is so, he plays so greedy this game. Roaches getting a nice flank here, though. The siege tanks are RMCs. They do back up, though, knowing that there's just too much there for him to engage head on. Cleaning up some more crate. Burrow wasn't finished. He did just start Burrow moment, so he does have Burrow, which is going to help when that Burrow movement finishes. I mean, there's a reason why Mech died off. Burrow roaches are just, with movement, so damn good. So damn good. But there goes the siege up, going for that third base. Looks like, oh, nice play from Asuji, cutting off reinforcements here. That is going to be so helpful. Using the barracks, though, you never really see this when players play mech, where they use this barracks to get some form of vision on the high ground. Oh, man, these SCVs going to take a lot of losses right now.
Asuji playing a pretty good game here. I really love the choice, like you said, the Burrow movement along with Burrow here. He's going to choose about to push on forward here. Roach is being split decently well. Now that's only left his siege tanks. They're going to get cleaned up relatively fast. There's Ostoji defending left and right here and crushing the army of Rainbow. We can see now over double the supply for Ostoji, 75 to now the 155. Rainbow is floating over his third command center. It is an orbital command, so, you know, Rainbow will have to be spread out. The one thing, though, that will allow, you know, these things have a variety of range. Not a variety, but a huge amount of range. But you know what? Ostoji's just going to go for it here, looks like, with two siege tanks. Now Siege, a third is on the high ground, providing some extra DPS. A Burrow comes in, and now Ostoji is moving in for the kill. A scan goes down, but that's not going to stop this attack for the time being.
Yeah, I mean, this is just, this is why going mech straight up is not the best way to play this. It's there's different types of styles you have to open up to transition in the mech. But going straight up mech, I mean, the third player just goes, okay, I know how good roaches are. I'm going to go them the entire game, and then I'm going to kill you, because I can just shave off parts of your army, I can pick off reinforcements, even just engaging straight up in the siege tanks, even though Asuji lost a lot there. I mean, the roaches are cheap.
Cheap, cheap indeed, just like a little bird. And it looks like Ostoji's going to be pecking away now. There's the GG called from Rainbow. Ostoji takes game number one.
So bad. Oh, silence. I love you.
I make bad jokes all the time. That's what I do.
I like how you followed up with a peck, too. That was great.
Yeah.
Oh, but man, I mean, this is why you don't open mech. The way a lot of Turian players are playing mech now is you open up two racks, you do some drops, you get stim combat shield. You don't invest in the plus one, though. You get the just get stim combat shield. You control them with drops, and you apply pressure that way, because Hellions can't do it anymore. Zergs don't know how to stop them. Or you do the 1-1-1 style, where you get the Cloak Banshees and harass that way, and then transition to mech. But just going straight up mech, you have to harass the Zerg, or they're just going to just be able to trade Zergs or Roaches with you like that, and you can't play mech like that anymore, man. It just gets shut down too easily by Roaches.
Yeah, I mean, either Roach drops, Roach Burrow movement, you know, Mutalisk even shut it down, especially that kind of style where you're very low on missile turrets and anti-air in general. But let's go to a quick commercial break, shall we, Zoya, we're in between games here. And next we'll have game number two between Rainbow and Ostoji. This is the GGA Cup qualifier number two, brought to you by Azio and AMD. Stay tuned, ladies and gentlemen. Oh god, it's Zoya again.
He's one of my real-life friends.
I can't believe it's Zoya. I can't believe it's not Zoya. Right?
Yeah, that's it. It's not right. Well, this bracket is huge! Oh man, so...
That's what she said.
We have three rounds of best of three, and the finals are best of five.
Whoa.
Yeah, we got a lot of casting ahead of us. We are already in the best of three. Most people are in the second round of best. Most people are in the round of eight by now. Round of eight. There's a good amount of people. When we get back from the commercial break, I'll update the bracket.
I believe we're probably back from the commercial break by now.
We should be. Okay, so bracket update, nerds. So far, we have, in the round of 16, We have a lot of great players. We have Bishu, very powerful. Oh, is that? That says Dignitas Select on it, but he already